don't think we should have a problem against relegation teams.
Facing Misfits, there is the same threat as facing anyone else.
Obviously, they have veteran players, but I'm confident in my team and I think we can put on a good show.
We are good players, and if we had a good game where everyone is on the same page, we can beat anyone. We have beat the best team and we have lost against the worst team.
The last time we played Rockets, we had a really bad week. We were not improving, not finding the good drafts. I think they improved a lot since they changed the junglers.
Schalke has definitely, like, when they're ahead, like, they're destroying every team, but then they're kind of unstable at the moment.
Until now, it's been pretty easy. Like, we haven't had much competition playing through Champions Series, since all the other teams have been pretty mediocre at best. I don't expect LCS to be anywhere near as easy as Champions Series.
We can easily beat them. It's going to be more a fight against ourselves.
From Berlin, Germany for day two of the 2017 Spring Promotion Tournament. Tonight, four teams fight for their EULCS lives and three will survive as we see Rocket there. Setting up on stage, ready for their second day in the promotion tournament. Hello, I'm Efe Schok-Deportre, joined here at the analyst desk by Daniel Tifa-Drakos, as well as Splice's Mickey X and Trashy. Well, I said Mickey X now, I've said Mickey the whole time, but now you're here. How would you like us to say it?
I don't know. Mickey is fine.
Mickey is fine? Okay. Well,
on the record. I love
there
it.
There we go. Well, welcome for covering, and thank you for covering the promotion tournament with us.
You're welcome. So. I mean, for us, if we can't play the tournament, then the second best is being here on the show, right?
And talk which about you prefer, it. Probably.
I mean, I don't know. Like, I've been playing in the promotion tournament for as long as I can remember, so I don't know.
Muscle memory. At least you're here. You get to talk about it.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Let's take a look at the bracket. Obviously, yesterday Rocket already played and won versus Millennium in five games. And then today they will be going up against Schalke and Origin will be taking on Misfits. Did you guys happen to take a look at that best of five yesterday, Mickey? What did you think of Rocket Millennium?
Yeah, the series was pretty intense. I didn't know which way it was going to go. But yeah, the Sona Mid pick was quite interesting. But yeah, I think Rocket deserved to win at the end.
I
think a fair statement is to say that if Rocket are not going to show better play than they showed yesterday, they're probably going to lose today against Schalke. And I think the series yesterday was two teams that were playing at a kind of low level, and I expect Rocket to show better play today.
You've played in a lot of promotion tournaments, as you said yourself, I'm not trying to flame here, but it always seems like these matches always tend to be five games and super dragged out, even when sometimes a team is clearly better than the other. What's that about?
I mean, all I can talk about is how I did it myself, and I think last split when we played the promotion tournaments against Giants, they had a fairly weak showing in their first game, and then when they played us, they actually played a lot better, and we also played pretty bad there. So I think there's just so much on the line. Like, it's so stressful, and you really feel the pressure when you go on that stage for these games, and you overall play a bit worse, I think.
Yeah, the pressure will be on as Rocket moves on to face Schalke today in the double elimination stage of the tournament on EULCS2. And meanwhile, Origin will be looking to redeem their disappointing summer split when they face off with Challenger Series champions Misfits on EULCS1. We're going to start by taking a deeper dive into OG versus Misfits, but first, as said, double elimination. Luckily for some of these teams, if they lose today, they still get another chance on Sunday.
Definitely get a chance at redemption. But my big question is, between these two teams, like, who's going to qualify straight up? Because if OG move down, they're most likely going to face Rocket, if our predictions are correct about the Rocket versus Schalke match. And that match, very volatile. So I think for OG to win here would be a huge boon for them. But I'm really skeptical given their most recent performances.
And also skeptical seeing how good Misfits has done in Challenger. We're going to take a look at a table of their goal differences. They crushed everyone in Challenger, that is safe to say. Mickey, of course the numbers are very impressive, but did you happen to catch some of the Misfits games in Challenger? What do you think of them?
Watched some of their games, and all the games are pretty stompy, so I don't know what to take from them, except that they're pretty good, so we have to see about it today.
Yeah.
I think what's interesting to talk about is that they changed their jungler, so and from what I watched, a lot of their games were Ignar and their former jungler Wisdom kind of controlling the game and doing a lot of roam plays and setting up the pace of the game, and I don't know how they will do with their new jungler. We'll have to see. honestly, I'm not 100% going with the Misfit hype that they're just going to crush OG super hot. I want to see it myself first. I think when they played the Challenger Finals against Millennium, they had the first game where it was a really slow game. And if they have a slow game against Millennium, I don't know how it's going to be in the first game against OG. So I think a lot of it will come down to momentum in the games and who is actually going to get ahead from the start of the series.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Let's focus in on some more matchups. You mentioned the jungle matchup in the top lane. Soaz versus Alfari is something we have our eyes on. Soaz, been around for so long, has had incredible heights as a top laner, and now he's up against this up-and-comer in Alfari.
And Alfari, of course, a reasonably talented player, definitely the top of the challenger ladder in terms of individual talent, very strong in lane. I got the chance to talk to Soaz a little bit before this. He says, thinks he's a great laner, has a lot of respect for them, but still feels pretty confident in the matchup. Now, you guys have seen both these players. Who do you think has the edge here?
Who do you think?
I wouldn't know, but I think it's pretty even.
What do you think, Tracy?
I think Alfari is probably a bit better. I think he plays more champions that are like the carry champions. I know he's a great GP player, and I think he also plays Fiora at a really high level. So I think if those are the champions that are going to be played, it all comes down to who is going to play better with the jungler and setting up a lead in the top lane. So I don't think we will see like one of them solo killing each other. I think it's more about how they set up their lane with the jungler and using that.
Yeah, something that Mickey might know a bit more about, the bottom lane, super hyped, Hansama and Ignar for Misfits, and you are one of those players who's super hyped as well, currently in the European LCS. What do you know about them? How do you think they can go up against Peke and Hybrid?
I've played a lot of duo queues with Hansama as well, and I think he's really highly mechanical player, so I have high hopes for him. But yeah, I've played some games with Ignar as well in solo queue, and he seems really good. So I think the hype that they have behind them is deserved. And yeah, we should see about that.
Possible 2v2 lane versus Peke, who is starting, and Hybrid. How do you see that going?
I think Misfits should have the upper hand in that matchup.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very soft-spoken and polite. We'll see what happens after first game, obviously. Not trying to beat you here. We also are going to take a look.
It's disciplined.
Yeah, it is. Oh, well, can I get a prediction for Origin Misfits, actually?
I think Misfits are going to win 3-1.
Hmm. Oof. I'm going to go with 3-1 OG.
Wow. Okay, let's revisit that after a couple of games.
I'm going to say 3-1 Misfits. I'm in the Misfits camp. I cast them for Challenger Split. Huh. You watch them stomp enough games, you start to believe.
Okay, well, let's take a look at the other match that's happening on EULCS2. Rocket will play Schalke. When we look at the story of Schalke in the summer of 2016, they prepared well coming into the split. They were good in the beginning, but they thought it was a sprint when it was actually a marathon, and they didn't make it in the end. They found themselves in the promotion tournament. What's kind of your view on the team Schalke and what they've done, because they did start off really, really good?
Yeah, I mean, it must be rough for their players when in the middle of the season they were like, oh, we're fighting for a top three spot, like the top three, and then it just went downhill. Like they couldn't find consistency in their play, and I think today will depend a lot on their mentality going into the games, because I'm not sure how well their mental is after like this split. I hope they go into the games with a mentality that they want to redeem themselves and show that they're actually good team. But I'm not too sure. And I think a lot of it always comes down to Gilius, how he's going to play. So
it's good that you mentioned that, because
yeah,
our featured matchup here is actually going to be Gilius versus Memento. These are two junglers that I've called polarizing. When Gilius does well, Schalke seems to do really well. I'm curious what you thought of Memento's play on Rocket yesterday, consistently picking up that Hecarim. What do you think he did for the team?
Actually, when I watch the games, you get these kind of clips where you hear the voice of the teams, like how they do in team fights, talking, etc. And I was actually surprised, because he, for a rookie, he was kind of leading the team, and he's like, we go here, and he was kind of leading the team that we're gonna win this fight, and etc. Right, and I think that actually surprised me a bit. I was impressed by that, and I think it kind of shows that he really wanna show that he's a good player, and he really wanna prove that he can play at the highest level, and I respect that. So I think yesterday he was one of the main reasons why they could bring home the victory.
Well, I just heard that the players are about ready, so I'm just going to get your predictions. Are you going to be the opposite again for the other match? What do you think, Freshy?
No, I have to go with my boy Gilius here. He has to redeem. He has absorbed so much now, yeah, that this has to be the game. You
basically
know,
like a sponge.
Yeah.
Mickey?
Yeah, I think Schalke is also going to win. I'm going to say 3-0.
3-0.
All right, after yesterday, my confidence in 3-0s is out the window. I'm going to say Schalke 3-2. I do not think this is going to be as clean as a lot of people expect.
Okay, well, we will see what happens for that game between Schalke and Rocket. We're going to send it over to the studio in EULCS2. Guys, take it away. And then Origin.
Hello, everyone. I'm Richard Polskamp here at the desk with Martin de Fischer at Lunga to bring you this best of five between Lunga. It's Schalke and Rocket coming up very shortly. I want to follow on the conversation there. They were talking about predictions. Can I get your prediction here?
My prediction, I think Schalke is the favorites after what we saw yesterday from Rocket. I expected Rocket to take down Millennium without any problems. Wasn't the case.
That's what we both thought.
We both, you know, expected it. So now I'm like, Schalke is the favorites. However, it is promotion tournament. Mm-hmm. You know, the mental state of the team is very important. These two teams have been losing a lot lately. So, like, the first game can decide a lot mentally for the next one. But I'm going to say Schalke 3-1.
3-1. Okay, I'm going to say 3-1 as well. Actually, no, we need some controversy here on the desk. 3-0, Rocket.
Boring.
We'll do that one.
Boring.
Let's get into this series here. So let's take a look at the roster starting off this one. Schalke will be first up with their top laner, Steve. Got no crowd here, unfortunately, to yell his name.
Steve!
But there we go. We've got Deficio, Jungle Gilius, mid lane Fox, ADC, Mr. Rales, with support Sprattle, and their coach, Niff.
Yes, Pulse. And today...
Oh, nice notebook.
They are, of course, facing Rocket on the other side, with Parang up in the top lane, Memento in the jungle, Betsy mid lane, the MVP yesterday, Steelback. As the AD carry race support grabs as the coach. Let's see if his notebook is as fancy as Niff's notebook. Ooh, I'm not giving that a 10 out
More
of 10.
More sleek.
The one page as well kind of ruins it, where it flies
true.
Out.
Yeah. Maybe he's looking at four different pages at the same time.
He's that smart of a coach.
Exactly.
Cool.
He has the multitasking talent. But yesterday, Steelback, honestly, kind of what we expected. We were coming in today, it's just like, Steelback, going to do well.
Yeah.
His positioning was impeccable pretty much for the entire series. Had some really standout performances as well.
He got his Lucian, he got his Sivir, because yesterday a lot of the bans were targeted at the top laners. 80% of the bans were actually against top laners. Parang had like 3 bans against him almost every single game.
Yep.
And he had to play Rumble, where... Not a fan of his Rumble specifically. The ulties went a little bit left and right. He died in lane a few times. However, first ban is not a top lane ban unless...
It
the Alistar.
Be. No, it's not going to be the Alistar, unfortunately. But you miss every single shot you don't take to Fisher when it comes to predictions.
I hyped up Lulu.
I'll have you know that I predicted the top lane Nautilus before it came out. The
you
Yanaui
win,
as well.
You win.
I was wrong on that one, but the 66%, I'll take it. We've got bans coming through, though. Tam Kench aimed at Sprattle. We were taking a look at some of his pick champions recently in solo queue, what he's been practicing. Tam Kench, right up there.
Yeah, and Vitality also banned Tam Kench in their BO3 against Schalke we had last week with the tiebreaker game. Every game, Tam Kench was removed. Nidalee versus Gilius, no surprise. Karma on blue side because you want a first pick, something different. Could be a Malzahar, it's what I expect, and that's why you ban the Karma, because you don't want to give that as the first rotation, and that is why Rocket decides to ban away Malzahar. They predicted, we predicted, everyone in here predicted it, even our producer.
Even our producer, he just whispered in the air, he's like, you know what, going to be that Malzahar ban. First pickup of the Lucian, so going to be denying one, that from Steelback, and also giving it to Rallis. Steelback played a lot of Lucian yesterday, had some good performances on that champion.
Uh-huh. But Steelback had a good performance on Sivir as well, which he could pick. Doesn't have to take it first rotation. Here you can go for preferred jungler. And if there's a standout support pick, I like Trundle. I think he's a fantastic flex option. I would actually love to see Trundle first rotation above Braum, just because you can move him into two lanes. It's a good pick for Parang, who did struggle yesterday. So I think you go Trundle here, not the Braum. Just go Trundle plus your preferred jungle pick, and then you can move on. Or you pick the Vladimir. Fair enough.
Well, you can do that. We had some queries about Rocket's drafting phase yesterday because they were making some real odd gambles, at least in the first couple games and then a couple times later on into the series. But also picking up this Vladimir early as well. Interesting.
I think we might see Ryze coming in from Schalke. It's something a lot of players like to play against Vladimir because you're so strong in the 1v1. It's very hard for Vladimir then to kind of do anything against when I have pressure in that specific lane. Kassadin is another choice against the Vladimir as well, where it's kind of the same situation. Vladimir doesn't get full pressure in the lane because you can always jump him. You can always engage onto him. Vladimir obviously in the team fights will be extremely powerful, but I think Schalke are okay with getting the Kassadin here and the very early pick off Vladimir, because that means Gilius could get his preferred jungler, which is important.
I mean, it's what the analysts were talking about. It's kind of been our storyline for a while now that the team has a lot of... needs to put a lot of stock in Gilius and how he does and his performance and how he does in the early game and how he affects their team. So getting him that early lead will help them to that end. We are now waiting on the next two pickups. Coming in from Rocket, they have a Flex currently and also their mid laner.
Right, so definitely you could save your solo lane pick because you already showed mid lane, but they're actually showing both solo laners and that Trundle is going to the bottom lane just to last pick support, meaning they expected Schalke to potentially steal away something like the Gangplank, and they're like, no, we gotta lock it in, we need it. It's been a good pick for Parang. It's actually been banned quite a lot against him because people respect it quite
yesterday
a lot.
Yesterday too.
Yesterday as well, so he's getting a comfort pick now, and he won't be able to whiff all the Rumble ulties today.
So we're waiting on the top lane pick. They're toying with the idea of Gnar, but we have seen Echo
like
actually being picked up in Korea against Gangplank, but not going to be this game. I like that matchup a lot, but I don't get to talk about it, unfortunately. Gnar will be picked up here into that Gangplank, and Braum as a support here alongside Lucian. So again, classic strong lane.
So I think there's a lot of strong picks on the side of Rocket here. Like all four picks they've already locked in are super good in the current meta. My problem is how early they show the different picks. They show Trundle as support. After second rotation, they show both solo laners, even showing the mid laner in first rotation. They actually allowed Schalke on blue side to counterpick both solo laners. And now you also get like a Lucian Braum lane, which is a good 2v2 lane overall. So Schalke have some very good lanes here and a better early game jungler in Elise. And the reason it's important is because you have Kassadin in the mid lane. And when you have Kassadin, you need strong lanes around him to protect him. Otherwise, the enemy team, if they can like beat you on the side lanes and roam mid and destroy the Kassadin, well, he's out of the game, he's useless, right? But if you have like good top lane 1v1, good bot lane 2v2, better jungle matchup, Kassadin should not be in any problems to be allowed to farm up to two items and go into his side lane. And Gnar does really well against Gangplank, like really well. You don't care about Gangplank, there's nothing he can really do against you. So Schalke with some very strong lanes here and Gilius set up to carry the early game on this Elise against a Karagas who's not going to do a whole lot.
I mean, it's pretty much perfect setup here for Schalke and how they want to play out this game against Rocket. And we're coming into this series, we said it at the start as well, looking at Schalke being the favorites coming in here up against Rocket.
Yeah.
And I think even coming out of Champion Select have done an exceptionally good job with those picks and bans.
I think if Rocket can lane swap, not fall too far behind the early game and actually get into a late game team fight, I think Rocket can still win the game, but it's going to be tough.
It's going to be tough indeed. A lot to go up against. The final pick was, of course, Jhin as well, as we didn't quite mention that at the end of Champions
League. We don't
there.
Care about Jhin.
With Rocket, we do, though, because yesterday we saw a lot of carry performances from the bot lane coming out of Steelback. We had a lot of supporting mid laners as well. But either way, DeFizio, with picks and bans completed, it is time to get into a first game of this best of five series between Schalke and Rocket.
Hype!
We want to stay in the LCS no matter what. It's like, it's your pride, you know? It's not only about Schalke, but also myself. I don't want to get relegated.
When they're ahead, like, they're destroying every team, but then they're kind of unstable at the moment.
I respect everyone, but I don't fear anyone.
If we don't win that game, it's going to be harder and harder for us.
I guess you could say Steelback has Northia in this game up against Schalke.
I think Steve, you know, he got it. He understands the system here. If they do not win today, it will be harder and harder to qualify.
Mm-hmm.
He's not wrong, because then they have to play on Sunday against the loser of Origin and Misfits. Let's see Parang here.
Oh, did not want to turn that
the
corner.
Top lane.
Oh, no. Well, that's no flash for the start of the game for Parang. 5 minutes on the count for that. Summon a spell. And Schalke will head into this jungle. There will be a Gragas coming up here. Memento is going to see Spraddle as he comes in here. We'll land a body slam, but he immediately sees the Spider Queen and will think seconds of going into the top lane and trying to get some vision down. So Schalke will get the early vision, get the lane swap ward, and mosey on out to Fissio.
Well, try and see if they can spot where Rocket is sending the dual lane, because Schalke really wants standard lanes here. Gnar against Gangplank is a good matchup for Gnar. The 2v2 is strong from Schalke as well. And you want to set up Gilius to carry it. But if it's a lane swap, you know, as a jungler, you just divide the map. It's kind of like, meh. Can't really gank a whole lot other than maybe the mid lane, and that's about it. But ganking for a Kassadin in the early game kind of suck. You know, he's just kind of standing there looking at you, doing all the work.
Yep.
And then he tries to steal the kill. I mean, we've all been there. I'm not ganking for a Kassadin.
Hey, but you want the Kassadin to get those
kills,
though.
Yeah, but he can work for it himself.
Okay,
I'm not
all right.
Walk in there and do everything. So they spot the dual lane on top side, Pulse, and look at this. They're coming to the top lane.
And we got Australia lanes coming in here. So, okay, so was it Rocket looking for the lane swap here?
Yes.
Trying to get out of that horrible 1v1 matchup and 2v2 matchup, actually?
Definitely a Rocket looking to lane swap. As I said, denied the jungle early game. Avoid these 2v2 and 1v1 matchups. In the silence, I think the 2v2 top is okay.
Yep.
For Rocket, that's not the problem. It's more than Gnar can be annoying, and the Elise can be annoying. So I think this is going to be okay on top side. Not the biggest issue. Plus, if you're Rocket, you want to scale up. You want to get to late game, right? You got a Gragas, you got a Gangplank, you got a Vladimir. All these champions here, they want to scale, they want to get to big late game team fights. I'm using my hands a lot here, even though the camera's not on me. Just for you, Pulse, this is a personal
for
show
me.
For
okay.
you. You can see how focused and into this topic I am.
Jat hands.
Late game, Jat hands, spider form.
That was a great video. That's old school.
One
as
of
well.
My favorite videos, and then the one Spazzy actually made about me.
Yeah.
That's also one of my favorites. Not too obviously.
Nice self promotion there,
Deficio. Talk too much about myself.
But during one of our breaks, if you are at home there, you should definitely check those out. It made me giggle.
Giggle?
Having a giggle. Well, Gillis is having a giggle because he's completely died this crap from Memento.
Gillis is what I call a mad lad.
A mad lad. Explain.
In the way, you know, Gillis is the kind of guy who always, always, always wants to carry the game. He always wants to be in your face. He wants to show how good he is. Even in games where he doesn't need to show anything, he's like, no, no, boys. Hang on.
Hang on.
We're winning every fight, but let me just pull up this insane three-man insect kick into Baron Steel, into killing two towers by looking at them, and then we'll totally win the game even harder. Mm-hmm. Well, you don't need to, right? You don't always have to. Sometimes, maybe. Sometimes you gotta gank the Kassadin.
Well, Betsy goes down into the Sanguine Pool, but the flash and the E in for Memento will result in a very easy first blood.
Why even flash?
Easy as can be for Rocket.
Let's blame it on promotion tournament nerfs. Flashing after you're already dead. He just kind of flashed on the other side of the Gragas, which still just bumped him in the head.
Yeah. Hey, that's what Trashy was saying. People generally just kind of seem to play worse with the pressure on them in a promotion tournament. The flash wasn't needed. And it's funny, coming from Fox as well, who is a player that we highlight, but like he's not an outspoken player, but he consistently does well. He's not
sure.
a bad mid laner.
No, he's been a good mid laner this split. I started out really well. Was actually the best mid laner in Europe for a few weeks. Mm. Then I feel like a lot of the other mid laners kind of caught up to him. Interesting enough that Rocket are able to pull off the first gank with the Gragas here, so perfect start from Rocket. Memento, well executed gank. The only way to survive this is if you flash when you see the body slam animation, but then he can actually technically still try and flash after you and still hit you. It's really difficult to avoid these kind of ganks. Just don't flash after. Surrender, you know, you die once, it's okay.
Yep.
Keep your flash so the guy can't return. Obviously, Kassadin will hit level 6 fairly soon, but great start from Rocket, and Memento was one of the best players yesterday, in my opinion, from Rocket. And today, starting off really well.
Yeah, no doubt. Steelback was, of course, the MVP of that team because Steelback just did Steelback things. But Memento as well, out of the jungle, really setting up his team. Had a lot of Hecarim games as well. Parang got targeted a lot. He was forced in that Rumble. He just didn't seem to understand how Rumble worked a lot of the time. It was like, I can 1v1 this Jax. Wait, I just died and he still has 60% of his health remaining.
It is weird, you know, when you normally play top laners who are single target ulties. Mm-hmm. And you're like, Rumble ulti? Probably single target, right? Is that one Jax over there? Yep. Let me just lay down the red carpet for him. And everyone else is kind of running around and you're like, huh.
Rumble, didn't work.
Rumble kind of sucked then, right? Also, he tried to TP flank on it. That was kind of weird.
Yep.
But let's not talk too much about the Rumble performance. Instead, let's talk about the fact
he has GP.
That he has GP. Obviously, again, tough lane matchup. We mentioned it 500 times. Make sure you guys know we're only 6 minutes in. We want you to know that Gnar is going to GP in the lane. Mm-hmm. Again, if you didn't get it, ask us on Twitter. We can tell you again.
We can explain it.
We can definitely explain it. But in this situation here, Betsy is doing just fine because the first gank was great.
Therefore, Vladimir has advantage in lane, means he can push in Fox, which is what he's doing. And then Gillius, maybe he can find a gank. You know, there's a cough button, right? So when you take a drink, then you can mute yourself. And
I didn't realize I was going to make that sound while drinking, but I want the crowd to know that I'm staying hydrated.
Okay, that's important, folks.
It is very
Stay
important
hydrated.
In life. Don't ever forget to drink.
You
will die.
You don't do the pro player drinking, though.
The one where you kind of move it around your microphone a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't have to because our mics are not right in front of our mouths.
That's true.
It's a caster tip.
But with Crepo, it was like hardwired into him.
Yeah. Yeah. See, I'm the opposite. I just move my microphone a little bit away from my mouth, and I just drink normally. Mm. I consider that better.
Got a fan vote coming in here. 60%.
So as you can see, five people have voted.
No, that wouldn't fit at all. No, that
10
would.
People
that
has
would.
Voted.
Five people could work.
Yeah, could actually
work. Three and two.
But I was going to say 10 people voted.
Yeah.
Six people for
you
Schalke.
You could say 100. You could say any multiple of five to Fischio, yeah. And it would be possible.
Did you vote, Pulse?
No, because I'm not biased. If I was to vote, I would be voting for both teams. However, both of us predicted Schalke wins. So.
Nice bias.
Yeah. Steve, there you can see the matchup punishing Parang. In this 1-on-1.
It's very simple, Pulse. When you play Gangplank,
25 CS advantage, 24, 25.
Yeah. When you play Gangplank, if you're against something that doesn't have a gap closer, you're going to be okay. So let's say you're playing against a Trundle. Trundle can't really close the gap easily because he tries to pillow you. You know, you walk out, you eat an orange, it's all okay.
Right.
Against anything that can kind of close the gap and get onto you, you kind of struggle because you're squishy, you don't have enough damage in the early game, you got to set up barrels, reset your passive, and they can auto-attack the barrel as well and kill it, and you just don't really have any way to duel them 1v1. Gnar can very easily close that gap, has a slow, has a jump, range as well, like everything you need to win this matchup. So it is rough for Parang here, but we see Gilius has opted into just kind of power farming. Hmm. Memento setting up for another gank. Level 6 Kassadin this time around. No flash though.
He jumps in as well. The Rift Walk, and in comes the Sanguine Pool for the slow. The Body Slam flash, and again, rinse and repeat. Betsy with the kill this time.
I would love for Schalke to ward around the mid lane. Seeing as Memento's been here twice now, and there was no flash on the Kassadin, mm-hmm. I feel like that's where you kind of cover your side lanes. Oh, sorry, you cover your sides off the mid lane.
Sure.
Because this is really bad for Schalke now. We mentioned how Schalke had good lanes around the Kassadin and early game jungler to protect him, so he should not be able to fall behind. And yet, Memento's been able to gank freely twice and take a mid tower. Losing mid towers Kassadin at 9 minutes is like the worst that can ever happen. Because you're too weak to go side lane already, you need to keep farming mid, but Vladimir can now push you all the way down to tier 2, and then Vladimir can move to side lane to put pressure. Like, I am so surprised Schalke has allowed this to happen in mid. I actually thought they would focus mid lane themselves, just because the way Schalke has won games in the past is by camping mid lane over and over, and Betsy is a player who can overextend quite a bit. He's like a discount Faker. You know, Faker will always go aggressive to trade. Betsy does the same, and often gets punished by junglers, except in this game, Memento's just been able to gank for him.
Doesn't make a whole lot of sense. He was pretty much on the dot. Whoops. Raise, accidentally sidestepping the ultimate coming in there from Spraddle, and that will be the end of that engage.
Tried to predict the movement, I guess. Gilius showing up. Will be spotted by two wards, not just one. So now he gets double division. And I just realized calling someone discount Faker is quite a compliment.
Yeah.
Like, that is not bad. That is definitely not bad.
Hey,
so
and Betsy's not being an awful mid laner.
No. Betsy's definitely also been a good mid laner overall. Let's see. Steve has spotted the gang on bottom side. Both junglers has been noticed on the map. Memento, he doesn't care. Just
doesn't
wants
have
to help.
Flash this time around as well.
That's true.
It's also because on the dot, like his flash came back up. He appeared mid lane, and like Fox wasn't like, I wonder. So Gragas has his full combo available now.
Yeah, basically, obviously, when you play Gragas, you have the reduced summoner spell cooldown from your masteries. So his flash was up slightly before the Kassadin's flash. Well, that's an easy gank to pull off. Just use that window. Really good timing from Memento, and this is what I really like about him. He's like, he's never trying to do anything too fancy. He does what's needed from him. He's consistent in what he's doing. And instead of putting his laners behind by him trying to 1v1 someone, no, he tries to just gank for his laners instead and being like, Betsy, now you should carry. Okay, Steelback, now you should carry. He's just very, very, very good at being a team player, which is rare for a rookie, honestly. They often come in and they're like, they want to carry the whole show. Same with some of the new casters coming in. They always want to carry the entire show. Us old people have to just kind of
retirement home.
Have to realize that we are not the hot stuff anymore. Mm-hmm.
Gotta move aside.
Gotta move aside for the new guys.
Yeah. But Gilius, no, he's gotta carry every single game. But this time he's farming a little bit more.
Nice transition.
Yeah. Well, I was also watching an interview recently with Gilius, and he was like, whoever comes out of Rock at Millennium, gonna destroy them. It's not even gonna be close.
I mean, they come in here as the best of the three relegation teams.
Yes.
Ended number eight. Had to obviously play the tiebreaker against Vitality. Lost the tiebreaker, funny enough. No surprise. That's why they're here.
Yeah.
So we should assume they were the best. Also with Origin and Rocket struggling so much. So on the map right now, as we mentioned, you see a Kassadin with no tower. Early on in the game, getting pushed really far back, having zero pressure on the map. The only thing he can do is technically teleport to the side lane. But he's just trying to keep Betsy in mid. Steve might be setting up a gank here. Well, I call it a gank. It's a welcome gift.
Yeah. He was just saying hello on his pilgrimage top lane.
What is it he's throwing in this one?
A boomerang.
Is it a boomerang in this skin?
Oh, wait.
It's a weird look. Oh, it is. It is. You're right.
I actually don't know. Hold on. I think it's a pipe. I think it's a pipe, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Not entirely sure, but I'm going to assume it is. Here's Gentleman Gnar, after all. That's going to be the towers exchanged, top and bottom, but Rockhat maintained that one tower lead in this game. Haven't had a whole lot of interaction, really just those ganks mid lane onto Fox.
Yeah, and then Rocket realizing they would eventually lose that top tower in the 2v2, so they swapped to bottom lane to trade towers. Mm. Get the first move on Dragon as well. Really good move from Rocket once again. It's very important, guys, to always notice. If you're like losing your lane, or not losing, but if you're under pressure in your lane, sometimes just trying to get it pushed out and then instant recall and swap the lanes will give you just a 5-6 seconds advantage, which in professional play is enough to like trade objectives and then go for a second objective, which is what they did here by rushing for that Dragon. Because what the other team has to do, well, they're recalling after killing tower. Yeah. So, you know, they will take extra time before they show up. Infernal Drake for Rocket, great early game so far with a strong team fighting composition. Mm-hmm. It was supposed to struggle a bit in the early game against what Schalke drafted, except for the Kassadin.
We were expecting that, but we were also expecting Rocket to play a little bit better today because they're against a known opponent. They know Schalke. They didn't know Millennium. So it was like maybe Rocket will just know how they play, feel a bit more comfortable, and that seems to be what's happening in this game, just a little bit. Because they now have this advantage in the early game.
Well, it's also Schalke is not putting any pressure on them. Like,
true.
We haven't seen a single gank other than Steve, who jumped in, threw his pipe-looking thing in the face of Betsy, and that was it. There's been no other pressure in the early game from Schalke. So it's been very easy for Rocket, honestly, and Memento. Like, whenever he had flash ready, he went mid, he ganked, and he got a kill. And then he got his flash again, he did the same.
Well, he's got flash available now again, so there could be a possibility. Mid tower's already dead, so it's a little bit harder now that Fox will go all the way back to his inner turret.
Yeah, it's not really your target anymore, right, in the
maybe
mid lane?
Maybe he goes bot lane.
Well, I mean, whenever you have flash and Gragas, you can pull off the sick ganks. Bottom side, we get another 2v2. And also, Parang is almost sitting on Trinity 4, so some good spikes incoming soon for Rocket. Betsy going with their... the second choice of Vladimir builds, we have the Spirit Visage rush into Rylai's, and then the other one is you go Abyssal into Protobelt, and then you go Rylai's as a third item. You can also put the Rylai's second there. Gets a little bit more damage than going Spirit Visage, but not as much sustain as the other one. Big fight about to happen.
Once Spraddle is getting in here, in comes the GP, ultimate repel comes up, and Rylai is getting pinned in place. Spraddle is gonna body block for him. Facial Fissure comes down, and Spraddle is the first one to die in this fight. Steve comes in, mops up the first kill, is very close to Mega Form, gets the ult onto two players, but instantly dies. Fox on his way out, steal back, doesn't land the deadly flourish, should not be able to secure this final kill onto Fox, but that's still a 4-for-1 advantage Rocket.
Oh, this is looking almost too good for Rocket now, just getting everything. First big fight, and Schalke end up running in one by one almost, just getting taken down. Rocket looking so good right now in game one. Steelback picks up some kills. Betsy's been part of everything. He's getting pretty fed on this Vladimir. Let's see it again. So we have 4v4 on the bottom side, and both top laners TPing in. And it's because they dive onto Memento while he dashes out. So now Rylai's is in the middle of everything. Betsy almost takes him down alone. Steelback tries to help with a few shots. And now the AD carry is gone. Damage from Schalke is kind of gone at this point. Kassadin is not really strong yet. While we talked about this Abyssal Scepter rush on Vladimir, it makes him much better on one item in terms of his damage. And Betsy was able to take over the fight together with the rest of the team. What a great start. And again, remember guys, this Rocket composition, great team fighting later as well.
Yep. Rylai's literally just walked in there and died. He had zero damage in that team fight.
Not sure why he dashed forward for Memento. I think he tried to just stun him before he could body slam away and see if they can burst him down. But it's such a risky play against the Gragas. Memento able to just dash out of the fight, stay alive for most of it. And allow Betsy to be like, is that an AD carry right in front of me?
I guess I'll just shoot him.
I will probably just chunk him down to like 20% HP and let my AD carry finish him. Or then, my gangplank in the end.
Yeah. I think he bled out from Deathfire Grasp actually from Steelback. I'm not sure. I'd have to
he
go
died.
Back and check.
He,
either way, he died.
Did.
It was a he is indeed dead. 4-1 in that fight. Rockhat just coming out ahead and everything really. Steve did have the character there to back off. That's actually something we didn't see yesterday with Millennium. It was just like, people are missing from the map. I'll stay underneath my tower and die. So that is a distinction you can make between Challenger and LCS teams, but it doesn't matter in this one. Rockhat still get the tower, they still get an advantage.
I'm pretty sure Shalke and that last team fight were like, let's run forward and fight and just shoot whatever is close to us. Is that a Gragas? Sure, shoot the Gragas. And now we overextended, now we died. Rockhat not really having to do a whole lot, honestly. Shalke is playing really poorly here in game one. And that is tough. We mentioned before the game started about the mental state of teams. When you've been losing a lot of games, you end up in a promotion tournament, you know, there's some trust issues maybe internally. Start losing the first game in a promotion tournament, BU5. Ooh, you can very quickly start doubting your team, yourself, your picks,
maybe
life, the world, the casters. There's a lot of people you can criticize.
I mean, I was standing here, and because it's quite quiet in the studio right now, I was listening to what Schalke was saying and Gilius was saying, just stay calm, communicate a lot, and repeat all win conditions.
Mm. So basically, so like casting.
Exactly, just repeat the win conditions, which is keep on talking, stay calm, and carry on. So, for Schalke, what are their win conditions here? Because they didn't manage to capitalize in the early game with these winning lanes. They still have a fairly fed Gnar, but they're losing their team fights. Now what?
I mean, that's kind of a tough part, right? They have a 1-3-1 composition, and 1-3-1 is fantastic when you do well in the early game and you get to split up in your side lanes and you have at least one winning lane to play around. I mean, one winning side lane to play around. You need your mid lane, the three-man mid lane, the jungle support AD carry to also be strong enough to actually push that mid lane to do anything in 1-3-1. Right now, that three-man group from Schalke is weaker than the one from Rockhat. Because this Gragas is very strong. Steelback is sitting almost on Duskblade and Ghostblade now.
2-0-2.
So Schalke actually will only have one winning lane in the 1-3-1. That's the top lane. That's not enough. You need your mid lane pushing as well. So right now, in order for Schalke to win the game, they actually will rely on Rockhat making a mistake. And allowing Schalke to take over mid lane and that side lane with the Gnar. Otherwise, you can never set up your 1-3-1, you can never invade enemy jungle, you can never put pressure, you know, on something like a Baron right after. Rockhat will be the team having that pressure, and Rockhat is the team who wants to teamfight you. So if you're forced to teamfight your way out of Schalke, you have to outplay Rockhat completely to win this game. And that's always the risk in 1-3-1 and casting compositions. It's high risk, high reward.
And they found Rallas once again. Will be altered back into the three-man stack. Spraddle trying to keep him alive. Brings up the
Water
Unbreakable,
stun.
But a good W coming out. Spraddle is going to have to body block all of these. It's going to hurt from this final shot as well. 312 crit.
And this is what happens, guys. Look, this was the 3v3 in the mid lane. Make it even 3v2 because Gilius wasn't there, but we talk about the groups in the mid. We don't talk about side lane champions. We just talk about AD carry jungle support facing each other. Rockhat just went straight for Rallas. They didn't care. They knew they were going to be stronger. Even if Gilius showed up, Rockhat would have been stronger in that fight. Pushing Schalke all the way back to tier 2 tower, almost killing Rallas. So again, despite having the Gnar pushing on top, Gnar can never do anything. Because if he pushes all the way to the enemy tower, there's a high chance Rockhat just moved from mid up behind him and kills him. It's really hard for Schalke to play split push when you don't have control in mid. And that's what Rockhat is looking for, that constant control in the mid lane, able to force fights. Memento didn't even use a flash in the last one, and now there's none on Rallas, so he can actually body slam flash him and kill him.
And it's honestly surprising as well coming into this game. It's like Schalke super confident. They draft this composition, winning lanes, are going to be hyper aggressive early game. Gilius farms through the jungle, top lane does its own thing, and then bot lane doesn't get super far ahead, mid lane gets camped. It's just like, what is going on? And Rockhat playing significantly better than yesterday, mind you. And he did have that winning record against Schalke a couple of weeks back as well, but I wasn't expecting just to see a rinse and repeat, a carbon copy of that game. coming out of yesterday, but call it what you want, Rocket getting momentum or Rocket just knowing what to do in this game, they're just playing better.
I just like that Rocket hasn't really taken any chances. You know, every play they've made have been very safe, very simple.
Yeah.
The quick partisan flash ganks in mid, where you just kill the guy in like a second and a half. It's not really any risk involved. Mm-hmm. You have enough vision around you to just go for the gank. And then the team fight in the river was great. Another fight around the mid lane, guys, we talked about it. Look how Rocket is so much stronger, constantly looking for the fight, forcing Schalke back, stopping the side lanes from ever pushing. Now Betsy should be able to push out this bot lane. While yes, again, the gankbot will get pushed in. Remember, he has ulti. If fight happens anywhere, GP will ulti instantly and then TP after, having more impact than a normal TP user. So perfect setup from Rocket after they didn't get punished in the mid game.
Well, Gilius was thinking about trying to punish Parang in the top lane, but Parang is already standing at his tower, already standing in the bush, already just farming these minions and trying to get the sneaky barrel there onto Fox.
I mean, Parang's only job is just don't die.
Just
like,
don't
no
die
no matter what.
He's 1-0-4. He survived the laning phase. He's already hit Triforce.
Barrel the minion waves, and in case they come up two guys and force you off tower, just DP ult to the minion wave. Just literally stop them from ever killing your tower and killing you. That's all you care about. Schalke finally get a chance to actually push out a lane because Rocket took Dragon and recalled and kind of tried to reset the map. But that's not enough. You know, it's only one side lane pushing for you. Rocket is back mid lane. It's always the fun thing. You can see 1-3-1 comps getting control of two lanes and looking very strong. You're like, ooh, there's almost no answer. And then you see 1-3-1 comps falling behind early, only winning one lane. And they're suddenly like, oh, we can't do anything. We have to team fight now.
Yep.
And it becomes really difficult to win them.
And so it's like, oh, I'm actually weaker at that, and it's not working out for us. And we saw that last team fight as well.
Steve is the hero.
I'm getting called out. Steve, yeah, he's completely out farming Parang. Probably will Flame Horizon him this game. So either he has to just hit the most sick Gnar ultimate of all time, or have his team just kill over and die.
I mean, that's a key thing to highlight. Shalga's composition, if they get a proper flank in a team fight, can still win a fight. It's just much harder than playing the 1-3-1 only play side lanes game that they originally planned on doing with their composition. Memento looking to engage mid lane.
Yeah, it's actually Raze coming in here with the pillar. Sprello is turning around onto Memento. Ultimate coming down from the GP, looking to assist. Steve TP's into the fight already mega form, but Rocket has just disengaged. Fox was trying the assassinate on Steelback, but only gets him low-ish. Betsy now rotating into the mid lane. He will find Gilius. Raze getting in here. He will have a pillar soon, no doubt. In comes the curtain call, connecting onto Rallis the second, looking for the foot onto Spraddle for the finish off. Hemoplate, not enough, but the barrel will be. Fox is going to go down here, but it's the bot lane who perishes first.
Whoa.
Betsy jumps forwards. There's a kill onto Fox. Gilius trying to get out of life. Steve, yes, he's still healthy, but there's no team here anymore. Three kills to Rocket.
I'm not sure what happened to this Rocket team here, Pulse, but they're playing really well now compared to yesterday.
Like, we see my prediction?
Well, suddenly, they engage the fight, obviously knowing they don't have teleport on Betsy, so as soon as they see the TP from Schalke, they back out, they just disengage. They wait for Betsy to roam all the way down. Steve is gonna die as well.
He didn't really achieve anything. Comes out the Sanguine Pool, Tides of Blood, easy kill to Betsy. Let's get the Vladmoor fed. Let's go back onto the Baron. No one dies from Raka. Baron at 25 minutes, 10 kills, massive advantage.
Such a good setup. Start fight, CTP back out, wait for Betsy to roam from top lane. Once Betsy arrives, you re-engage. This is the first engage. 3v3 as always, guys. We talked about it tons of times in this game. They see the teleport, they back away because they know Betsy's running from top lane. So they wait for Betsy to arrive now. By time, Schalke stays. Not respecting the fact that Betsy shows up, Gilius way too far forward. And now, Rocket, in a 5-on-5, re-engages with a fed Vladimir. Great ultis from Steelback in the back as well. And they have a better team fighting composition. They're heading gold, they're heading kills, they win the fight. That was just a very smart setup from Rocket. And because of it, they pick up more kills and a Baron.
And you see the damage there from last team fight as well. Steelback, Betsy always pulling their weight. And as you mentioned, Rocket does better at these team fights right now. Steve, maybe caught with his pants down, will be jumping over this pillar. Betsy and Raze on the front lines, just gonna take this tower away. Do not need to fight here. Just take the tower, back away, or open up with the curtain call, chase down Steve. Memento gonna be following after as well. There's
Rocket
the big
someone?
Barrel.
Nope.
That is dead Steve. Rocket gonna keep on chasing.
All right, Schalke doesn't like Steve anymore. Confirmed from that little play. That's going to be a tower going down. Pulse, that's going to be an inhib going down.
Yep. Rockup take the tower. They'll be going onto the in hip. They have that kill onto Steve.
Stomp. It's game one.
Yep.
You come in here, you prepare for this the entire week. You watched the game yesterday at Schalke. And Rocket looked awful, honestly. And you're like, well, I mean, we should be heavy favorites now, right? If you're Schalke, after watching the game against Millennium, and in game one, you are getting stomped by Rocket. I mean, mentally, that can destroy you.
Yep. Absolutely ridiculous, especially coming into the day as well. It's just like, we were looking at yesterday, and we even said on the analyst desk, like, Rocket and Millennium, no matter who wins here, Schalke will be rubbing their hands together and being like, all right, boys, we're back in the LCS. Should be an easy series. And then now we're standing right here with almost a 10,000 gold lead as we get towards the 30-minute mark. Middle tower instantly disintegrates from Rocket, and they just need to go from lane to lane, taking objective after objective. And this should be an easy clear out for them.
Yeah, and it's important to highlight that we're obviously basing a lot of this on Rocket's performance yesterday and not Rocket the last few weeks of the LCS, because
they're on the upswing.
Yeah, they got better once they got Memento, and where Schalke was still slumping, Rocket slightly improved, and they were very close to each other. As we highlight, week 8, Rocket beat Schalke 2-0, and now they're facing each other here after Rocket obviously beating Millennium yesterday.
I mean, Rocket took a game off Fnatic as well, and looked very good in that game. So Rocket have been doing pretty well coming up to the end of that split.
I'm just glad to see them step up and not play like yesterday, because yeah, this is nothing like the Rocket we saw yesterday against Millennium. Maybe they were nervous, maybe they didn't know what they were facing.
Sure.
But this is a whole different piece. Steve going
this
in.
This is Steve's Steve going out to get a big ultimate, but he doesn't get it onto anyone. And Betsy is in the base looking for an ultimate. Two-man tides of blood, finds the first kill. Spratle trying to run away for dear life, but Betsy, he's in hot pursuit. The rest of the team turning onto Steve. Steve jumps over the wall, but Steelback, he's going to flash after him with the dancing grenade. Picks up that kill. Two kills to Rockhat, and with the rest of the team unable to contest, Rockhat at 29 minutes into this game are closing in on the Nexus. They're onto the Nexus turret. The first one's dead. The second one soon to follow. Spratle putting up a stellar defense, but there's nothing really he can do. The rest of the team is just on their spawn pad, and Rocket gonna clean up this first game in convincing fashion.
29 minutes, 12,000 gold lead, 13 kills to one. What a massive stomp. Rocket, great early game, love the ganks towards the mid lane. Won the first team fight in the river and had full control. Honestly, yeah, they picked up dragons. The team fight in the mid lane, perfect, honestly. Engaging, see TPs, back out, wait for Betsy. Schalke stays, fine, re-engage, win the fight, pick up Baron.
Mm-hmm.
Rocket didn't make a single mistake in this game. Not the same team we saw yesterday. I'm really happy to see them bounce back and show up big time here for game one, because this is massive for them in terms of confidence and knowing, hey guys, we are much better than what we showed. We heard Steelback in an interview yesterday being like, this was bad, like we didn't show up.
Should have gone to five games.
Again, we should not go five games. We have to be a much better team tomorrow if you want to win. Well, congratulations, right now you are a much better team just from one game. Yep. That was beautiful to watch.
And you can say the exact opposite for Schalke. I mean, he must be feeling horrible right now coming into this game, getting destroyed in game one. And also drafting a composition where we're like, yep, top lane should win, bottom lane should win, mid lane should be fine and able to farm, jungle should be able to get everywhere and get people farmed up. He just farmed himself and nothing really happened with the game. Like, we didn't see anything really from Schalke.
No tower dives, anything.
And we got to the point where it's just like, well, this composition doesn't work. And they got ran over by Rocket, so
they lost mid tower at 9 minutes because Memento got to gank the mid lane twice. And just take down the mid laner twice. And it was like, all right, we take mid tower. And now you get to push a cast in to a tier 2 tower at like 10 minutes.
Yep.
It makes it really hard to do anything as a jungler. If your mid laner is losing as a jungler, you don't feel like you can go anywhere because the enemy mid laner can just walk down behind you and you get collapsed on and you die. So really, really great start from Rocket, and such a bad start from Schalke. I did not expect to see them honestly do nothing.
Me neither, Deficient. You can see Rocket right there discussing their game plans, but we were just talking about the two early kills that we saw that set up the rest of the game. We're going to take a look at that replay very shortly. Just that first blood, and the major point from this was it was just an easy gank from Memento. It was like, oh, my flash is up. Flash, body slam, boom, kill. What, 4 minutes later, I think it's like 255 seconds when you have the mastery. Comes in again. Oh, no flash. All right, I'm going to kill you again.
Yeah.
And it was just, there we can see. Literally what we just talked about.
So pre-level 6 caster then, always great to gank him. Beautiful setup. Really not a whole lot you can do once you've caught, once you're caught in the mid lane,
yeah.
Gilly shows up in the end, but like obviously too late for him. So that's already the first gank pulled off. Advantage Rocket. You said to yourself, return, do the same thing again.
Yeah.
Betsy gets Abyssal Scepter first item, so he's even stronger than normal, like more damage than normal. Following teamfight, pull up the replay straight away. Rallus and the rest of Schalke ends up jumping into the open arms of Betsy. If you look at this fight here, to go from Memento, dash forward, and now you're right in front of the Vladimir with the Abyssal Scepter.
Yeah.
And what's this up, Steelback? I think it is the Deathfire Grasp ticking off there. And
actually, yeah. No, it's the Trundle ult.
No? Ah, Substigate. Yeah. Because there was no bloom of the gym passive.
Well,
but
you don't actually take the E that earliest gen. A lot of players don't. Mm-hmm. They take it like level 12 something up there because they're like, oh, we don't need it in the laning phase. I like it, just it gives push control. But
yeah, it's that one point.
That's for these players. Gotta keep in mind, professional players all about optimizing your damage. Mm-hmm.
Every little bit counts.
Every little bit counts. Getting an extra skill maybe in your W instead of getting that E rank is better.
Yep.
So that is obviously what they decide to do on most Jhin players decide to do. But again, really this game, Rocket way better than Schalke. Massive changes have to happen in terms of how Schalke plays the early game.
Yep.
They can pick the same draft if they want to. This has got to be way more aggressive early on. And what for your mid laner, please? Like, don't let a Gragas get two ganks off.
Especially after the first kill as well. It's just like, oh, I wonder what Gragas is going to do from here. Oh, yeah, go mid lane again and kill him again. We're going to take a look at the final fight. Just, I was going to say a sentence I can't say on air. We're just going to take a look at it. And
this is where Schalke is sending a message to Steve that they don't like him anymore, even though Steve actually was the best player in this game from Schalke.
He was the chosen one in this in this game, and unfortunately, Rocket had the high ground. So
everyone peacing out.
Schalke had no way to win. and that was the end of the game, pretty much.
29 minutes, Paul.
The game was over before this point.
Oh, of course. I mean, had they jumped in to try and defend him, probably would have died as well. That's always the problem. I just want to see Schalke's adaptation now, in-game. Because they're going to be red side the next game. The teams will swap every game. Because again, if you go for the same kind of draft, you know, they got to now be able to identify what went wrong in the early game. How did this guy pull off two ganks? Okay, what should our jungle have done? Should he have done anything? Should have been bot lane, ganking the gangplank, you know, dive him on a tower.
Sure.
Elise can dive gangplank super easy.
Yeah.
So you got a discussion of what happened in the early game, how do we fix it? Problem is that 15-minute fight in the river you guys saw where they all jump into Vladimir, that's the kind of stuff you don't really fix between games because that's where every player is like, oh yeah, I knew it, I messed up, you know.
Yeah.
As soon as I did it, I knew it was wrong. And like, you can't really fix it then when everyone's like, yeah, we knew it was a mistake instantly. That's where you kind of go like, okay, don't do it next game, and then you hope they don't do it.
Yeah.
But that's kind of the problem. So it's more you look at the early game, how did Kassadin fall behind? What could we have done different? Because they got standard lanes as well. It was a great start from Schalke overall.
Yeah, they got in there. They got the vision. They made sure that they could get the lanes. Well, forced the TP in from top lane. It was just like, it looked like everything was going to go well. It's like, look, they have step one of their game plan, and they just, I don't know, lost their papers, didn't know what was going on. And it's just like, I guess we just kind of lost there. So, yeah, just need to see adaptation coming in there from Schalke, most honestly, here DeFizio. But it is time for us to take a quick break, so don't go anywhere, because when we come back, we'll have game 2 in this best of 5 between Rocket and Schalke.